Then you see in this exclusive cell phone video hear gunshots. They are about 50 feet away from Michael Brown and Officer Darren Wilson. The unidentified person recording this video captured the witness's reaction during the final moments of the shooting. Both men were contractors working in the area. They did not want to be identified. The man on the left in the pink shirt told CNN they heard one gunshot. Then, about 30 seconds later, a second shot. He says he saw Michael Brown staggering. Then he says Brown put his hands up and said, "Okay, okay, okay." The witness told us the cop didn't say get on the ground, he just kept shooting. That same witness described the gruesome scene, saying he saw Michael Brown's brains come out of his head, again reiterating his hands were up. Watch how he motions on the video. The video, these witnesses say, was taken shortly after the shooting ended. If you look closely, you can see a police officer in the distance beginning to put up crime scene tape. Both men told us by the time it was over, there were three officers on the scene, but only one involved in the shooting.
So this is very important for a couple of reasons. Number one, for some insane reason, some people didn't believe the folks in Ferguson.
Right.
So, you know, I don't know why they make that assumption, but you can take a guess at why they make that assumption, right? Everybody that saw it on the ground, the witnesses in Ferguson said he had his hands up.
And his back turned. He was trying to run away.
Right. In the beginning, back turned, trying to run away. And then he turns around, and then that's when he gets shot, even though he's clearly not posing a danger, according to these contractors, according to every witness, right? But no. Cops are always right. The black people they shoot are always wrong. When other black people stick up for them, well, they're from the community, of course, they're going to say that. What is it? Like, it was a grand plan to get Michael Brown executed, so what? The community could do what with that? Like, what? Right. You know what I'm saying? It's so, but people believe it. So in this case, these people are not from Ferguson. They're from outside of Ferguson. They're contractors. I don't know what the guy in the pink shirt is. I can't tell his ethnicity. The guy in the green shirt who corroborates everything the guy in the pink shirt said.
Right.
White, clearly white. Does that help you that a white person said it? Does that help? Okay.
I think it's important that more and more of these videos kind of come out and we have more details as to what happened, because it's really easy to sit back as someone who's not a witness to the crime scene and say, oh, I think that this happened, or speculate that that happened. But as you get more evidence and more witness testimony of what occurred that day, it's inconceivable that he did not have his hands up. He did have his hands up. He was not posing an imminent threat to the cop at that time. He was unarmed. And this is important information for federal investigators to look at when they're investigating this case. Now, there is the second part of this video I want you to take a look at. This is the account of the gentleman wearing the green shirt. So take a look at that.
Another voice is also heard on the tape. The contractor in the green shirt told me that voice belongs to a man he didn't know who pulled up alongside them, yelling this. That same contractor in green also told me that he saw Michael Brown running away from the police car. He said Brown put his hands up and that the officer was chasing him. He also said that Officer Wilson fired another shot at Brown while his back was turned. The contractor in the pink shirt also shared this, that a second officer who arrived later to the scene also drew his weapon. He said, the one cop was the one who shot him. Then I saw the other officer pull a gun out, but he didn't shoot. That same worker described how Brown staggered dead after the second shot 20 to 25 feet to the ground, explaining he was like a walking dead guy.
So the other reason why this is important is it gives you more context.
Right.
That there was another cop there, but he didn't shoot because there wasn't a threat.
Right.
And now everybody agrees the guy has his hands up, and a cop shoots him anyway, right? And both of those guys see it. They corroborate every other witness. And when you look at it in total, now, look, we're not saying, hence, we should find the cop, drag him out of his house, and execute him. Nobody's saying that. We're saying, based on overwhelming evidence, you should arrest the guy, and we should go to a trial, right?
Absolutely. And I think it's important to really delve into this story, investigate it, and hold people accountable, especially if you're worried about excessive force, police brutality. That is a widespread issue that not only impacts minorities, but impacts everyone. every day there's story after story of cops using lethal force when they don't necessarily need to use lethal force. And so if you really genuinely care about that, you would be in favor of evidence. You would be in favor of a full investigation. And I like what you said, Cenk, because this is not a lynching of the cop. This is not us trying to like go after him and ruin his life. This is us trying to hold him accountable if he had done something wrong, right? Mm-hmm. And the only way you're gonna find out is if you're open to the evidence that comes out. And there is a slow and steady trickle of these videos and these witness testimonies.
Yeah, because idiots like Ben Stein say, oh, we're lynching the cops. No, Michael Brown is dead. The cop is perfectly alive, right? And so we're just looking for justice. And justice means the justice system. And conservatives on Fox News love to say like, oh, don't be biased. Well, if you see all this evidence and you don't want to arrest the guy, aren't you being biased? Why wouldn't you arrest a guy that every witness says executed a guy who had his hands up?